what they had to say in the build-up to their most important head-to-head clash to date.
We'll bring in a better performance than we did there with the 5-1, and we know that. There will be a totally different commitment than we brought in that day. So I don't think both teams, quality-wise, are a big difference between each other, so the best team will win.
From our point of view, we are ready to play, to work hard.
If you work for Sky or as a manager, you're looking forward to that kind of games, and me too.
But they are playing from their professional pride, and
hopefully we can do it on a football matter, and that's the most important thing. And hopefully for us, for me as a manager for Rangers, that we are the better side in the day.
We are not going to speak about the defeat before the game, and
we will go out with a good spirit. You can expect that, but you can expect that from Celtic as well. Hopefully it will be an exciting game.
The thoughts of the two managers, well, the atmosphere, as you can expect, building good style at Celtic Park. Celtic have had some great moments against Rangers this season. Rangers are looking for their 100th win. Just under two-thirds of Celtic's league wins have come at home. Well, Celtic fans, of course, are here in big, big numbers tonight, hugely outnumbering Rangers supporters. And these supporters you're seeing are desperate that their side wins tonight. And well, the odds are about as tight as you'll ever get, with Celtic just favourites at 11-8. It's 13-8 Rangers with the draw at 11-5. Who'll score first tonight? Well, Henrik Larsson of Celtic is favourite at 4-1. Rangers' Rod Wallace is 5-1. Neil McCann, there's a good bet. He's at 12-1. You'll see that one shortly. Further down the line, Colin Henry is 40-1. And maybe the bonkers bet, Enrico Annone. Sorry, Enrico, 80-1 he is tonight. Well, the old firm have met three times this season. The first of those came in September. Well, going into that match, Rangers were top with 10 points from 5 games played, while Celtic were lying fourth, 2 points worse off.
Larsson knocked it down, and Burnley! No wonder. Goal! Here goes Albert. Steaming towards goal, George Albert. He sets up Rod Wallace. Was crowded out. Here's Wallace, and here's Amato, and Gould, has he done enough to smother it? He just about has.
Football, I think, yeah, in the games, to be fair, there were a lot less football in the games, but now it's so much more open. And in that particular game, as Charlie says, there were so many chances. It was an indicator for the season, really. And it's just gone on, and the games that followed have been great as well.
Yeah, yes, but indeed. I think they've been constantly exciting, Jim, and I think we'll get the same again tonight.
Well, by the time the sides met in November, Rangers 10 points. With 20 games gone, Rangers were still top, with Kilmarnock clinging to second and Celtic in third. When you didn't beat Celtic home or away?
Probably. I can't remember offhand, but it's, all in all, it's such a big event for both sets of teams, for different reasons. Obviously, Rangers are very much favourites to win the championship, but the fact that Rangers can go to Parkhead and win it just adds so much more spice to this one.
Spice is right. So the scene is set. Rangers could win the title tonight. Celtic, on their own patch of course, are desperate to stop them doing just that. Celtic against Rangers is live after this.
One draw tonight, John.
Trevor Stephen?
Well, decimated squad for Celtic. I think that plays into Rangers' hands and I'll go for a Rangers win.
OK, Celtic Rangers, let's join our commentary team, Ian Crocker and Davey Provan.
Thank you, Jim. Well, before we get going, you may all like to pause for breath. There's a good chance you won't be able to again for about 90 minutes or so, because the deadliest of deadly rivals, the Giants of Glasgow, are about to collide. Celtic are utterly decimated by injuries, with Gould, Blinker, Burley, McNamara, McKinley and Mialbi all amongst the casualties. If this game had been played yesterday, Paul Lambert wouldn't have made it either, but they patched him up and he takes the captain's armband with Tom Boyd suspended. Stubbs, Mahi and Brattback all return to the starting lineup, and Scott Marshall, on loan from Southampton, is thrown in at the deep end for his Celtic debut. Tommy Johnson, out injured for a year, makes the bench.
Well, they don't come any bigger in, and what a night it's going to be for Scott Marshall. I thought that Joseph Engloss would have played Vidar Reset in that back three and bring Simon Donnelly in, but Marshall comes in and he'll play in a back three in which I think Rico Annone will pick up Gabriel Amato. I think Annone has the physical stature to do that job. Further forward, I think Vikhorst and Lambert, although Lambert, we're told, isn't 100% fit, will be absolutely crucial. They'll go head-to-head with Alberts and Van Bronckhorst, and I think the outcome of that contest will really have a great bearing on this match. The real problem, though, for Rangers tonight is what to do with this man, Henrik Larsson. Normally plays one of a front two, playing in the hole tonight, much in the same position that Rod Wallace will play for Rangers. And it gives Dick Advocaat a decision to make. Does he let Larsson roam in that area, or does he go man for man on him?
There's no Andrei Kanchelskis for Rangers. He's suffering from a virus. But Neil McCann, George Albertz and Tony Vidmar have all recovered from injuries. Gabriel Amato, not surprisingly, keeps his place after a man of the match performance against Aberdeen last week. And he was an inspiration too in the New Year Old Firm derby. American international captain Claudio Reyna gets his first taste of an Old Firm derby. He's been itching for this day, but then haven't we all?
It looks to be a straight 4-4-1-1 system by Dick Advocaat. He finished with a 3 against Aberdeen last Sunday, starts with a 4 tonight, and I would expect to see Colin Hendry pick up Marco Viduka. We know the physical presence that Viduka has, and we all saw what a marvellous job Hendry did on Oliver Bierhoff in Bremen in midweek. I think Hendry will pick him up. This man here, Claudio Reyna, we're told that was an anchor man in midfield. I think he may start right, but it wouldn't surprise me if he takes the full shift in here, plays in front of his back four and picks up Henrik Larsson. Neil McCann, wide left, will be the out ball for Rangers tonight. And I think as much as possible, we'll try to get him tramping on to be the reset.
You are about to witness something rather special. The Old Firm derby. Wonderful to watch. Victory for Rangers would clinch the championship, and on the ground of their fierce rivals. For Celtic fans, Rangers reclaiming the title would be bad enough, but to do it here, we're talking worst nightmares. But how the blue side of Glasgow would relish the moment if it does happen. It could be a derby day that will be talked about forever. A day that may deserve its own chapter in the enticing, intriguing, amazing story of Old Firm rivalry. Just soak up a little of the awesome atmosphere. Prepare yourself for Britain's biggest club match at Britain's biggest club ground. The lucky 60,000 inside Celtic Park, at their loudest and proudest. Listen to the noise, feel the tension, and experience the passion of Old Firm Derby Day. It's Celtic against Rangers. Upon us, temperatures are falling elsewhere, but not in the east end of Glasgow. Oh no, temperatures here are rising and rising and rising. Henrik Larsson is Scotland's player of the year and Sweden's player of the year. 38 goals, but only one in the last four games. That's a barren spell by his supreme standards. Rangers, though, will dread the dreadlocks today. Rod Wallace has enjoyed his best scoring season ever, 26 in his first season in Scotland. Is he about to add a Scottish title to the English title he won with Leeds United? What a day to make your debut. Scott Marshall, on loan from Southampton, takes his Celtic bow. It's only his third appearance of the season. In his two games for the Saints earlier in the campaign, he managed to score a goal in each. Sadly, they were own goals. Hugh Dallas was in charge of Rangers' last league victory over Celtic here on their way to 9 in a row a couple of seasons ago. 8 yellow cards, 2 red cards in that game. Just your typical old firm fare. He'll also referee the Scottish Cup final between these teams at the end of the month. Celtic aiming to go through a season without losing to Rangers for the first time in 11 years. All very good in the pride stakes, but in the prize stakes, Rangers are very much in the driving seat as they target a tremendous treble. There's no point getting comfortable in your seat, by the way. You'll only be using the edge of it. In 1967, Rangers drew with Celtic at Ibrox, a result that meant Celtic clinched the title. 32 years on, is it payback time? And a free kick for Celtic for the foul by Rayner on Veghorst.
Yeah, there'll be a few fiercely contested tussles early on, and I think it's important that Hugh Dallas, the best referee we have in this country, stamps his authority, and I think that's an indication that he's likely to do that.
Decision to body check Gio van Bronckhorst.
I don't think it'll be long before Hugh Dallas will produce a yellow card. I think they'll want to give an early message to the players here tonight. There's only so much he's going to let them away with.
It's going to be fast, fierce, but fascinating. Mahi. Aduka. Towards Bratman. Hidmark was impeded by Viduka.
Yeah, certainly was impeded there. And you see the physical strength of Marco Viduka here. And clearly using the arm to fend off Tony Vidmar. Neil McCann has actually started this game playing through the middle, much the same role that he played for Scotland against the Czech Republic on this very ground just a couple of weeks ago.
Duke and Vidmar opponents today, but teammates at international level with Australia. Albert making excellent progress. Here's McCann, and he's tried to pick out Wallace. Oh, and it cannoned off Anoni. And back into the hands of Kirk.
Yeah, Stefan Mahi does superbly well here. Neil McCann skins Rico Anoni here. Takes him on the outside. And look at Mahi, the outstretched leg. Rod Wallace had a tap in otherwise.
Not surprisingly. Whilst we were watching that replay, the ball quickly went from one end to the other. And now Sergio Parini has conceded a Celtic corner. It's a bit like that in the old firm games. Stefan Kloss, who hasn't looked at his most comfortable on crosses, has the likes of Stubbs to contend with here. Veghorst prepares to swing the corner in. But he won't be able to do it yet because the referee has spotted a bit of over-the-top jostling. I think they're stuck together, those two. Veghorst in the end saw his corner cleared by Amato. course, with a real high-hanging cross. That cross managed to punch it clear. And a free kick now going to Rangers, Lambert penalised.
Yeah, well, we're all surprised that Paul Lambert was going to play in this game in the first place here. Really not 100% fit, and he catches Rod Wallace just as he's going down there. It's a trailing leg.
Dr. Joe Venglos, unbeaten against Rangers this season. It's 11 years since Celtic managed to go through a campaign without losing to their arch rivals in the league. A Dutchman won the title last season, of course. That was Wim Jansen with Celtic, and Dick Advocaat follows suit with Rangers.
Well, he's been under real pressure. If you spend £56 million to win the Scottish Championship and you come up short, you're going to take some stick in this town, I'll tell you. And he must have been feeling the pressure in recent weeks.
He's a real no-nonsense character. And he's watching a real no-nonsense contest. And Bronckhorst to take this Rangers free kick. Hendry yet to score for Rangers. This will be a heck of a time. From Van Bronckhorst, but that will drift away. Disappointingly from a Rangers point of view, but delightfully from a Celtic point of view.
Yeah, it was a chance to put Stuart Kerr under pressure, and he still really has to get his first touch in the game. And it was just played in too deep there by Giovanni Van Bronckhorst. It's a chance for Stuart Kerr to get his gloves on the ball for the first time.
Stuart Kerr called upon for the last three games because of an injury to Jonathan Gould. On by Larsen. Arena. Amato, who scored one and set up the other for Rangers in the New Year Old Firm game. Wallace. Stubbs goes with him.
Looked sharp enough here, Alan Stubbs on Rod Wallace with the challenge. But one of just a number of Celtic players who must be sort of full match fitness.
Perini's long throw. Perini again. Ball won back fairly. Larsen unable to make much progress. Being watched by the Aston Villa manager John Gregory today. Celtic rejected a Villa bid earlier in the season. Brat back now. Is he barged out of the way? He was by Amoruso, and it's a free kick to Celtic.
Yeah, it's a rash challenge. It's needless as well. It was goal sight here. Lorenzo Amoruso. This, in fact, was Vida Risa. An example there of just how the pace of Harold Brattbach could trouble a Rangers defence playing with a flat four this evening.
Plenty of big men in the box for Henrik Larsen to aim for. The likes of Viduka and Weghorst and Brattbach and Stubbs. It's towards the far stick. Just flicked away by Van Bronckhorst. A Celtic throw. An easy catch for Stefan Kloss. It's the usual frantic fare so far. Magnificent to watch. What's it like to play in?
I'll tell you what, it's almost impossible to describe it, and you never become immune to this fixture or this atmosphere. It really is special, and even driving through the town tonight, you knew there was something special on. And once again, Dick Advocaat has foxed us all by playing Neil McCann through the middle. For a man who normally relies so much on natural width, he sacrificed it completely tonight with Neil McCann playing through the middle, and of course the absence of the Andre Kanchelskis because of a virus totally changed Rangers side this evening.
Mistake by a reset though has given Rangers possession with Perini. Hendry, magnificent for Scotland in Germany in midweek. McCann. Celtic fans near him cried handball. McCann's got away. And he gets there. Adam Stott. Claudio Reyna, Captain America, skipper of the USA. Free kick to Rangers, big horse that time, doing the impeding.
Yeah, he pulled him back, no question about that. Reyna away on the right-hand side here. Thank you, Dallas, just having a word with Morten Veikkaas, who I think will find the pace of this game pretty testing in the early stages, at least. Still on the way back to full fitness.
Rangers seeking their 100th league victory over Celtic today. If they get it, they are champions. McCann's header will drop behind for a goal kick. In the previous three Old Firm meetings this season, we've had two draws and a rather famous Celtic victory by 5-1. A result that would have hurt Dick Advocaat. Certainly hurt a few Rangers fans. Well, he finally realised it was coming through to him. Enrico Annone. From the Italian, although Bradbach's trying to make the best of a bad job, away by Amoruso.
It's not a bad area to hit though, when you have somebody with Bradbach's pace. It does get defenders turning that kind of ball.
Hiduka. Veikkaas trying to escape the crowd of Rangers players around him. Stubbs, Scott Marshall, that's a pitch of a pass that Larsson can sneak in. Vidmar just did enough and is assisted by Van Bronckhorst, who takes the direct route up to Neil McCann, and Annone is alert to his presence.
Yeah, Rico Annone seems to have been given the marking job on Neil McCann, and given McCann's form recently, it's going to be a demanding night for him. But he is very good at the man-marking job. And clearly, he's done it many a time in Italy.
Celtic's 5-1 win here in November. It's their biggest victory over Rangers for 33 years. Vidmar missed last week's game against Aberdeen with a leg injury. Van Bronckhorst slides it through here to Rod Waters, and it's in from McCann, and Rangers have the lead. And are they edging towards the title? Neil McCann is buried underneath his celebrating teammates.
Yeah, it all came from a good early ball from George Alberts to release Giovanni Van Bronckhorst here on the left. Rod Wallace wanted it in behind and got it, and nobody picked up Neil McCann at the front post. And although he's stretching, it's well controlled. All he's trying to do is get it on target, and nobody picked up McCann's run to the front post there. A well-worked move by Rangers, and a good finish from Neil McCann, who looks as sharp as a tack tonight.
Rangers draw, first blood. Chase for this, and it's a free kick to Rangers. Marshall fended him off unfairly.
Yeah, I mean, he tried to usher the ball out of play, and so often we see defenders getting the benefit of the doubt here. But it was a long way from the goal line when he tried to hold McCann off, and I think Hugh Dallas is right there.
take this free kick, and Celtic on the rack a little bit here. Already a goal down and having to contend with this. Although, to be fair, it wasn't much to contend with in the end. Another free kick going Rangers' way.
Yeah, Harold Brattbach just getting a bit carried away in the early part of the match here. Rod Wallace just fending him off. And the arm goes over the neck of Rod Wallace. Wallace just using his body strength there to hold the Norwegian off.
Reset. How will Celtic, severely depleted Celtic, respond to that Neil McCann goal? Here he is again, McCann. Now Wallace. It's going to be another Rangers free kick. Much to the frustration of Stefan Mahi and co.
Yeah, Celtic just losing their discipline here, and this will be a yellow card for dissent. And I don't think it's for the challenge, I think it's for the mouthing afterwards. And he claimed that Wallace used his right elbow, and he appeared to there, but the reaction of Mahi was unacceptable. And you just don't get away with this dissent when Hugh Dallas is in charge. The right elbow does go up, and he does have a point, but it was his reaction after that. I think he talked himself into a yellow card there.
Well, he got sent off in one of the Old Firm games last season. Definite dissent from Mahi. First yellow card of the game. There's a chance there might be some more. Lambert is now getting spoken to as well. He was also leading the Celtic protests in a rather fierce manner. One up. Stuart Kerr knows what is coming. In fact, he doesn't, because Alberts called everyone, including perhaps his own teammates. And I'm sure that worked on the training ground in midweek.
Well, you wouldn't be surprised to see George Alberts trying his luck from that distance. He's trying to knock it into Matteo's feet, but Scott Marshall did a good job in picking him up.
Celtic's way for Alberts' challenge. Stubbs. Kaduka chasing this, but Amoruso favourite to get there first. Hangs on to it grimly. Good recovering challenge from Kaduka.
Yeah, Amoruso just wanted too long in the ball here. That was a good sliding tackle by Viduka. That's going to be a fair old contest between that pair tonight.
And Russo made his Rangers debut against Celtic in last season's Scottish Cup semi. Goal by Neil McCann, the 116th Rangers have scored in all competitions this season. Only one club in Britain has managed more. Manchester United with 119. Alberts. Slipping it through here to Tony Vidmar. Celtic stretched again. Vidmar. Oh, it's eluded everyone.
Oh, what a chance, Rangers getting to the byline again. And it was Vidar Reset that was caught with the ball inside them there.
Can he exploit it? Mahi. He's inside Perini. Stephen Mahi! And Boss just got his fingertips of that. It looked for a moment like it might sneak through.
Yeah, he did well to work the space. He just wrong-foots Perini here, but he's coming onto his weaker right side. And it's not, in all honesty, an effort that was going to beat Stefan Kloss.
Here's Mr. Versatile, Vidar Riese. Played in every position for our keeper in his career. Wouldn't be surprised if that happened one day. Larsson. Clapback, the only man in the middle at the moment. Viduka. And here's Weghorst! Oh! A matter of an inch, perhaps.
Well, he timed his forward run to perfection here. And he's in behind Tony Vidmar. Stefan Kloss closes him down quickly, but he has to hit the target there. He has to at least, Stefan Kloss, make a save, and he's dragged it wide. But more encouraging from Celtic, both in the chance that Stefan Mahi had a moment ago, and now Morten Weghorst.
Touch that from McCann. It's released. Rod Wallace. Amato and McCann in the middle. Here's McCann again. Goal kick, and only just doing enough to put him off.
It's a great front post run again, though, from Neil McCann. As the ball comes in, he's stolen a yard on Rico Annone. And although he doesn't get it on target, he's under pressure from the Italian. It's another terrific run by Neil McCann. Wallace wasn't picked up first of all, and more importantly, nobody near Neil McCann as he tapped it into the net. And that will be the annoying thing for Josef Vengloth, that nobody was tight on him, he was never put under pressure.
George Albert, Giovanni van Bronckhorst. That McCann goal, only the eighth Celtic have conceded at home in the league this season. Too much on it for Mahi, but he will get there. Not to any great effect, though.
Yeah, Morten Weghorst just asking too much of his wing-back there.
The side flag immediately went up.
That would be disappointed in the manner the goal was lost. Nobody picked up Rod Wallace. And Neil McCann was unchallenged when he finished it off.
His free kick, powerfully met by Amoruso. These two meeting at the start of May, as they will at the end of May in the Scottish Cup final at Hampden Park. Bradback. Mahi. Duca. Free kick, and it's going to be a card for Amoruso, is it? No, it's... might be a little warning, maybe.
Yeah, that's a danger for Lorenzo Amoruso, that he gets a yellow card early on. And he doesn't take any of the ball there. And the fear for Amoruso would be, if he were to pick up a yellow card, could he get through the rest of the contest with Viduka without being shown a second one?
Noted. Larsson's free kick! Was the nearest man to it, but it was headed away by Hendrick. Annone. Lambert. Ma- Marshall. Rusev. And Rusev has got away from Van Bronckhorst, and he's delivered a decent cross. Stubbs is in there. Straight into the rather grateful gloves of Kloss.
Yeah, he had Marco Viduka at the back post. Rusev does work well to get away from Van Bronckhorst. A good deep cross. And look at Viduka at the back post, completely unmarked. And Stubbs just couldn't find the angle to put him in. Stefan Kloss under no real pressure there, but Marco Viduka knew that had it been squared to him, it would have been an easy chance.
Helvetz. Marshall. His brother Gordon plays in goal for Kilmarnock, of course. Reset. Viduka could latch onto this. And Amoruso sent it out for the throw.
Yeah, he did very well, not for the first time in the game either. And he's the wrong side of Viduka initially, but he manages to get goal side eventually and does enough.
Recently returned from a bad ankle injury. Mahi back from injury himself. Bratback. Veghorst. Bratback. Stepping his way through, Harold Bratback. Perhaps trying to be a little too ambitious. McCann. Such a live wire. An effort appreciated by the Rangers fans. Alberts broke his toe a couple of weeks ago, but you have to have more than a broken toe to miss out on a game like this. Never a quiet moment on the touchline when Dick Advocaat is around. Clearance goes straight to Perini. Reina. Now reset. Celtic fans trying to urge their team on. Larsson. Viduka putting himself about. Larsson. That was a little awkward. But Stubbs will get there. Morten Veghorst. Now Mahi. Viduka is shaken off. Amoruso, lovely touch to Mahi. And the flag is up for a free kick. The flag went up.
Well, the flag went up early. I thought for offside here. And it is offside, I think. Good reverse ball here from Marco Viduka. And it's very, very tight, very tight. Tony Vidmar may have been level with him. I think he's fractionally offside.
You really can't take your eyes off this one for a second. Rangers champions 47 times, Celtic 36. Hendry's header, Kloss is going to have to come out, and he does.
Yeah, he's always quick enough off his line, Stefan Kloss. Plays more or less as a sweeper at times.
Wallace just overran it, and that allowed Marshall to make the challenge. And Bronckhorst steamed in, mind you. Vidmar deciding on a change of scenery. Out he goes to the right, and Perini. Amato. Veghorst getting stuck into him. And the outcome of that little skirmish is a Rangers free kick.
Yeah, you just don't get this kind of time on the ball in this particular match. Gabriel Amato was dwelling on it. It's caught late there by Rico Annone, but
I think at times he is wanting too much time on the ball.
Marto, a big favourite with the Rangers fans. Not a big favourite with the manager, though. He's been a bit part player, really, this season. He gets his cross in, it's Vidmar rising. Put away by Stefan Mahi. Larsson. Vidar Riese. A late challenge then by Vidmar on Riese, who's going to bring a card.
Yeah, and he's unhappy about it, but he certainly did catch Vidar Riese late here as he switched the play from one side of the pitch to the other. Just plays it away here with the outside of his right foot. And he's taken late by Vidmar, the hand goes up.
Well, Vidar Riese. Well, Perini is also down as the ball went over towards the touchline. He was challenged as well. Reset now on his feet, Perini about to follow suit. Two bodies sprawled out, pretty normal really for this game.
Well, every 50-50 is so fiercely contested. And so far I think Hugh Dallas has handled it all superbly well.
Of Tony Vidmar's yellow card, joining Stefan Mahi in Hugh Dallas's notebook of naughty names. Here is Mahi. And a foul by McCann.
Well, Stefan Mahi has to calm down here. And more often than not, it's his mouth that gets him into bother.
He's off. It's Mahi, I think, for his retaliation then and his descent. Just as you were saying, Davey, that he should learn to keep his mouth shut. He's gone back to have a pop at Hugh Dallas, and his teammates have got to get Stefan Mahi away because he's losing it here big time.
Yeah, he's losing it. He's also losing it for his teammates as well because he's left Celtic with a real uphill struggle now. McCann booked for the initial challenge and Mahi was entitled to be unhappy with it, but his reaction was completely unacceptable and Celtic have to get him out of there.
Stefan Mahi is sent off in an Old Firm match for the second season running. Two yellow cards, both for dissent, and that is simply foolish.
Well, this isn't a young boy we're talking about here, this is a seasoned professional. And he knows the implications of being sent off. And it was a late tackle from Neil McCann here. Mahi had won the ball. He just tries to check back here, Mahi. And he's caught late, fair enough. But you have to get on with it. And it's something he says to Hugh Dallas here. And he's telling Hugh Dallas he has to boot Neil McCann. And I have to say, on reflection, they're looking at that, it is harsh. But he should know on a yellow card, he's treading thin ice, he has to keep his mouth shut. And he's chanced his arm with Hugh Dallas, and he's picked the wrong referee.
Well, everybody is so fired up for an occasion like this. But Stefan Mahi was a little too fired up. And he is distraught as he leaves the field of play, he's in tears.
I think you can see what it means to him. You have to draw the line, though, between wearing your heart on your sleeve and losing it. And he just lost it there completely.
So Celtic are down to 10 men. Oh, it's Stefan Kloss. And here's Riese. The initial header from Stubbs, saved by the keeper, and then scrambled behind.
Oh, it's the chance for Riese, though. That was the real chance. Kloss did well to get across the Stubbs header. Golden chance for reset as it breaks to him though. Kloss under pressure. And he snatched at it and took his eye off it.
Well, this is a game that always lives up to its billing. Extraordinary excitement. 10 men Celtic.
trailing Rangers.
It's a rewrite of the script 20 years ago, Ian, when Celtic clinched the title here with 10 men against Rangers. I wouldn't bet at the moment on history rewriting itself.
You played in that game, in that 4-2 win. Did you have a good game?
Of course I did. Very silly.
Neil McCann picked up a yellow card as a result of his challenge on Mahi, who also got a yellow card, but it was his second of the game. And that, as we all know, equals red. And Mahi looked ready, really, to almost assault Hugh Dallas. Quiet evening for Hugh, then.
I think it's a harsh sending off, but I think Stefan Mahi should have known better to get involved in the first place.
Drops here for Harold Brattbach. Larsson cut out by Amoruso. Well, it's been remarkable stuff so far, and it promises to get even more fiery. A goal down and a man down.
So far they haven't pulled either of the front two off the front to step back. I thought they would have pulled Viduka back and left Brad back up or vice versa, but so far the two of them are still pushing on to Lorenzo Amoruso and Colin Henry.
Marshall. Reset. Scott Marshall. Reset flicked it on. And Viduka felt he was given a little shot then from Amoruso. Hugh Dallas didn't think the same way.
He's been so tight on him from the word go. And he's handled Viduka very well tonight, Amoruso.
Bit of a battle of the heavyweights. Inside the last 10 minutes of the first half, can't believe it's gone that quickly actually. Maybe I should be used to it by now. Bidmar. Albert. Amato takes it over. He was about to have a go. Albert might be able to have a go. Good intervention from Reset. Smuggled it through to Larsson, looking for Brattbach. It's going to drift away though.
Yeah, Brattbach had made a good run, but he just got the angle of the delivery wrong. This was the moment that mattered. Rod Wallace not picked up. Neil McCann attacks the front post, and Rico Anoni can't get to him. And he's stretching, he's still a bit of work to do as the ball comes across. This in fact was a sending off. It's a late tackle, there's no question about that by Neil McCann. But Stefan Mahi already on a yellow card. And the one referee you don't get away with this with is Hugh Dallas.
And it stops. Reset. And Amato and Reset squaring up to each other now. Hugh Dallas was very quickly in then, brushed them both out of the way. Stubbs will take the free kick. It wasn't one of his better ones. came across, made it his, couldn't keep it in though.
I just wonder how much longer Celtic can play at this pace with only 10 men. And Rangers will sit in now and pace themselves, and they're always liable to hit Celtic on the break should Celtic continue to commit so many players forward.
Here in November, Rangers had a player sent off in the first half, Scott Wilson. This time around, it's happened to Celtic, and Stefan Mahi ordered off two yellow cards, both for dissent, and that really, when you're playing professionally at this level, is ridiculous.
Yeah, Sergio Perini was just away there from Morten Vikos, and late challenge from Vikos. And it's either a free kick or a corner out there.
It's going to be a free kick. No, it is a corner, I think. Rangers thought it might be a free kick. Hugh Dallas just telling Van Bronckhorst that we have to go back a couple of yards. Oh, it is a free kick, after all. I'll take it all back.
Oh, no, we've got a supporter on the pitch here.
Oh, dear. The stewards are quickly on. And this really is what was feared a little, but with this game being shown around the globe, just what we didn't need. It's quickly been dealt with, to be fair. Right, it is a free kick. I promise you.
Oh, Hugh Dallas has been hit here.
Hugh Dallas has been hit by something. And these are shocking scenes at Celtic Park.
Well, they put us all to shame, these scenes, Ian. And however hard we try to clean it up, the atmosphere at this fixture is nothing short of poisonous at times. And if you have people as irresponsible as this, what can you do with them? And Hugh Dallas out there for 250 quid or whatever, and he hardly deserves that, does he?
Not only that, he's done a very good job under difficult circumstances so far in this game. It's a real nasty gash for Hugh Dallas. He'll be patched up and he'll get on with it, I would imagine. Well, returning to football matters, a reminder that tomorrow we go from the top two in Scotland to the bottom two, Hearts against Dunfermline. A vital contest in the battle for survival. 5 o'clock, Sky Sports 1, tomorrow. Well, words almost fail you after an incident like that. Van Bronckhorst with the free kick. Challenge on him and a penalty. There's some confusion as to what is happening here.
Yeah, it's whipped into the back post. You can see reset his arms round Tony Vidmar there. I don't think he needed a lot of encouragement to go down, but the hands round the waist there. And he goes down. You can't question Hugh Dallas's courage in giving the decision.
There's another fan come on now, and this is getting absolutely desperate. This is becoming a really sorry day for football. And perhaps in this day and age, the passions involved in this game run far, far too high. It's a penalty to Rangers, and that means George Albert. Up steps the hammer, but he doesn't hammer it. He's side-footed into the corner, and Rangers are closing in on the new Scottish Premier League trophy.
Yeah, the perfect penalty there from George Albert. Didn't go for power, went for precision this time, and just knocked it inside the left-hand post. Fine penalty, Stuart Kerr guessing the wrong way. Good penalty from Albert. And we'll have some more commotion, I'm afraid.
Yes, I'm afraid, whilst we're watching that, yet another fan has come onto the pitch at the end where Stuart Kerr's goal is. George Albert with his 19th of the season, but the football, I'm afraid, is becoming incidental because fans are running on left, right and centre, being carted off by police and stewards. The referee, Hugh Dallas, hit by an object, perhaps a coin, and he needed to be patched up with blood pouring from a wound. What can you say, David?
Well, it's not sport, is it? I just wonder what the foreigners out there are thinking of this. And they come over here and they enrich your game, and they must wonder if it's all worthwhile at times.
So then, just thinking back to that decision from Hugh Dallas, what a decision to make after he'd been hit within seconds awarding a penalty.
Well, it might be seen as vindictive, but he was brave enough to point to the spot, and Reset was clearly holding at the back post there, arms round Tony Vidmar.
Brave decision, Lesserman. Might not have made it.
No question, the moment that mattered, though, the sending off of Stefan Mahi. That is when this game turned.
Here's Gabriel Amato. There's a public address announcement being made asking the spectators to stay off the field, and let's hope that the situation has calmed down a bit and that we can return to the football. Time in the first half. Stubbs. Away by Amoruso. Marshall. Deekhorst. Wallace.
Yeah, Celtic need one before half time if they'd have any chance at all.
Larson's free kick. Amoruso made contact with that. And it was nodded behind by Morten Veghorst.
Yeah, once again Amoruso was so tight on Viduka. And we've seen Viduka bully defenders this season. He hasn't managed it with Amoruso so far tonight. How tight he is there, good defending.
League horse header that time. Larson's quick free kick, looking for Pratt back here. And Kloss came, and Vidmar just did enough then to shield Bradback.
Yeah, it was a good run from Bradback. He's stolen behind Amoruso there. Good delivery from Larson, and Kloss once again did well.
Paul Lambert, Celtic's captain for the day in the absence of the suspended Tom Boyd. Reset. Scott Marshall. These two teams between them have accounted for the last 13 Scottish championships. Rangers with 10 of those, of course, as the whistle goes for half-time. And sadly, for Scottish football and the game in general, Hugh Dallas, the referee, was hit by an object, it seemed. He needed treatment with blood streaming from a head wound. Several fans ran on the pitch, but let's concentrate on the football aspect here. Rangers have the title in their sights after Neil McCann prodded in Rod Wallace's cross. And then just after Hugh Dallas had been hit and had had treatment, he made a very brave decision of awarding a penalty for recess challenge there on Vidmar. George Albert was cool, calm and composed. Not many others have been, sadly, inside Celtic Park this evening. At half-time in this Old Firm derby, it's Celtic 0, Rangers 2.
In a hectic and at times thoroughly ugly first half, is Celtic 0, Rangers 2. Stefan Mahy of Celtic was booked and then he was later sent off. Rangers' Vidmar and McCann have both been booked. And as that shows, Celtic have had more of the first half. Now, these are the scenes at Celtic Park as I speak. Sadly, there is a fan being treated in the crowd and unconfirmed reports have come to us that he's come down from the tier above. We sincerely hope that that is not the case and that it is not too serious for that supporter. So 2-0 Rangers, the football apart, that first half will be remembered for all the wrong reasons. Charlie Nicholas, I think everyone thoroughly disgusted by what we've seen.
Well, it's a sign of cowards again, Jim, you know, that come into our game. We've seen Hugh Dallas make a strong decision. It was a clear free kick for Rangers. Van Bronckhorst had to take his time. They were all a bit unsure whether it was a corner kick or a free kick. But it's unacceptable and it cannot be tolerated. These people should be hounded out, you know, and embarrassed themselves and let's make them suffer for a change. I mean, we've seen the coins coming down on top of Van Bronckhorst, who had to wait best part of a minute or so. But it's Kyles that's done it again, and how Hugh Dallas could get himself picked up and go on with this game is beyond me. It's just not acceptable.
Trevor, these games are always explosive, but we didn't want this. No one wanted this.
No, not at all. You could tell from the moment. You could look at Stefan Mahy, for instance, who was going around the field in a daze almost. And then Hugh
Dallas, as Charlie was mentioning, a dreadful moment there, Trevor.
Absolutely. It was. It's mayhem. It's madness. It's embarrassing for Scottish football because everybody gets tarnished with it. And the game was good up to the point, certainly when Mahy got sent off, that changed things. The game was going well, and Hugh Dallas was having a tremendous game. He was in charge of everything, and that spoiled it entirely.
Well, Charlie, let's go through the key moments of that first 45 minutes. Yeah. And Neil McCann, who seriously was up for this game, put Rangers 1-0.
Yeah, well, what Celtic have got, they've got lopsided because Anoni's man marking McCann, and Rangers have dragged him out of the right wing-back area. And they take advantage. Scott Marshall is caught in two minds. He doesn't know where to come or stay. And then they're all backtracking. It's a lovely cross from Wallace. And McCann is in beautiful position. His pace has been too much for Anoni. And he's been a constant problem for Celtic throughout the first half.
Yeah, completely torn apart there by Rangers. And as Charlie said, it's McCann who's just caused the problem. His pace, his movement, and that is where Celtic have been pulled apart. the only chance that Celtic had there was Wollaston put a good ball in, and he put a great ball in for McCann.
Well, Trevor, Mahé had been booked and then he was sent off, and he's been red carded not for the first time in Old Firm games. What was he thinking about here?
There's a lot of tension in the game, but you know, this is uncalled for, his reaction here. Prior to this, his booking was... he shouldn't have got the booking in the first place. And then this was just an overreaction. McCann has fouled him, there's no question of it. Hugh Dallas may have been going to, as he did, he in fact booked McCann. But this reaction from Mahé is asking for trouble. And as Ian Crocker said and David Provins said, you don't do that sort of thing with Hugh Dallas. You don't provoke him, he will react and get you the red card if it's necessary. And Mahé shouldn't have done it.
And Charlie, you don't do that kind of thing in an Old Firm game, as you know, as David Provins knew.
Listen, I mean, it's OK being fired up, but you've got to be controlled in certain areas. I think it actually worked badly and disadvantaged for him since his first booking. He got the yellow card, and quite rightly so, for a foul on him. He was complaining about it. He let Hugh Dallas know, but he continued for about another 10 or 15 seconds after that first booking. And that is never going to be forgotten
then,
by
then, as we know, Dallas was poleaxed by a coin shortly after that. And then penalty incident, amazingly. Penalty awarded to Rangers. And well, Trevor, was this a penalty? Charlie, was it a penalty?
Well, we were discussing it. We thought... it wasn't conclusive that it was a penalty. You see that very often in penalty areas. I don't think Hugh Dallas had the best of views on that. But there was, on replay, there was definitely a bit of pulling.
It's certainly a strong decision, Trevor. There's no doubt about that for Hugh Dallas. I mean, you can understand that he's under pressure constantly. I don't think it was a clear-cut penalty kick. But Hugh, I think, was in a decent position. I think he had the strength to do it, then you've got to go along with him.
Yeah.
I mean, he's made very few mistakes and he's taken a coin in the head for his troubles. But it was a strong decision, but I didn't think it was conclusive enough for me to give one.
Well, after all that, as things stand at Celtic Park, it is 2-0 to Rangers. But look at this. The supporter who think we fell from the top tier, singing as he's been carried out of the ground. We're back after this.
Well, Hugh Dallas will start the second half, and he's had four stitches in the head wound, resulted from being hit by a coin. It should have been a spectacular sporting event, but a mindless, moronic minority have had their say. For goodness sake, let's hope we can concentrate on the football in the second half. Produce a comeback of epic proportions, and that's a shocker from Viduka. He's given it straight to Albert. Amato wants it played ahead of him. Gabriel Amato, and between them, Anoni and Stubbs sorted out that particular problem.
Yeah, it all came from a slack pass from Marco Viduka trying to switch the play that put Albert in. And playing with 10 men is going to be hard enough without giving the ball away as Tuchel plays that.
To bring him to Celtic. 8 goals in 9 games, though, has rewarded Dr. Joe Venglos's faith in the Australian international. The general atmosphere has calmed down considerably.
Rangers haven't gone to a back three, which normally Dick Advocaat would do. Celtic still playing with two up front. But whether to go with a three, they would have a spare man at the back and also be able to push on another midfield player. Because at the moment Celtic are just matching up in midfield.
And Celtic will get the throw here.
He just tries to play a square ball inside and he's caught late by Rico Anoni. Fortunately, both his feet were off the ground.
straight at Wieghorst. Great Dane finds the super Swede. Just to put off Larsen's toes by Van Bronckhorst. An early goal in the second half would raise Celtic hopes, and how. Larsen. Player of the year, Sweden's player of the year too. 38 goals this season. He's created one or two more as well.
Yeah, Celtic really need one off him right now though, if they have any chance of getting back into this.
Marto appeared to catch Wieghorst then. Now Gabriel Amato. He's going to get the yellow card.
Well, here's a clash. Didn't play the ball, nowhere near the ball. I thought it was for elbows, I don't think so though. It's just clattered Morten Wieghorst after he heads it away.
Helped on by the Duca. Anoni. Stabbed out by Perini. Anoni. I'll bet could perhaps lead a Rangers charge here. Neil McCann helped it on. Rod Wallace is going to get to it. McCann continued advancing. His cross cleared by Anoni. He tried to trip Amato then.
Yeah, I think we thought about it. He did well actually when the ball came in from Neil McCann there to get in front of Gabriel Amato.
Challenge.
Yeah, his hand goes up right away there. No chance of playing the ball.
I'll bet. It's a bit too far out even for him to have a go from there, that's for sure. Perini. So that's going to carry through to Stuart Kerr. Only his third start of the season. They've all come in the last three games. Hendry clears. Up towards Amato. And Noni will be first to it. Helped on by Wieghorst. Larsen threads it through, looking for the Duca, and it just ran too far in front of him.
Yeah, it was well intentioned from Henrik Larsen, a fine ball threaded through there. The Duca was just a yard short of getting on the end of it, just beyond him. And a good pass from Henrik Larsen here. He's caught Rangers out there, Tony Vidmar trying to get back goal side of the Duca. He was never getting to it.
From Paduka. Cario Reyna. Lambert. Oh, and oh, he's caught it outside of his area, Stuart Kerr. And under pressure from McCann. There's another big decision for Hugh Dallas to make here, because a handball outside the area, it's only a yellow card.
Well, they wanted too long on it here, and Neil McCann closes him down quickly. He wants two attempts at it, and he comes up, and I think he acts instinctively there. McCann does well to get to him as quickly as he did, and before Cam Newton, the ball was in his hands.
Pure instinct from the keeper. It gives Herr Albert a chance to plan something here.
Yeah, Giovanni Van Bronckhorst scored from a very similar position back in November in this fixture.
Marusso also there, he likes to have a pop now and again. Normally from about 40 yards out, quite close for him. And Bronckhorst is away to the right. The Celtic wall ready to break, it's Amoruso! Oh, and somehow Kerr has managed to turn it over. I'm not quite sure how on earth that looped over.
Well, it's some save. It's well drilled in there by Amoruso. Stuart Kerr reacted very, very quickly, down low to his right. And he gets lucky there, it spins up over the crossbar. I wouldn't grudge him it after a save like that.
In comes the corner, which is well held by Kerr. He's had a busy couple of minutes. Reina's header. Albert's offside, surely. But the referee will let Celtic get on with it. Good advantage played. Here's Riise. It might have been a good advantage. McCann, he's away here. Amato and Albert are the men in the middle. McCann's cross, away by Anoni. It's going to come to Van Bronckhorst, though. It's not going to sit down for him. He couldn't improvise.
Good footwork here from Gabriel Amato. And he can throw a crunching tackle, first of all, from Morten Veghorst, before being brought down by the Dane. Maybe signs of tiredness just creeping into Celtic's game now. They did a lot of chasing in that first half after they went down to 10 men.
Alberts and Van Bronckhorst conspiring here. Van Bronckhorst to have a go. Hendry. Morten Veghorst encouraging Bratt back to make something the sort of run that he has, and that's a good cross shot, which is pushed away by Kos.
Yeah, it's the first time Rangers really have been caught with the ball in behind for Bratt back's pace. In behind Perini here, and he had to take it early, and that's a good effort. Bounce just in front of Stefan Kloss, and the goalkeeper had no choice but to beat it away.
Can Celtic find a way back into this old firm derby? Stubbs. Oh, and here's McCann and Anoni. Enrico Anoni needed to win that duel.
Yeah, four blue jerseys in support of Neil McCann, had he won it. Critical challenge there from Rico Anoni.
Amato. Referee has let Amato carry on. Van Bronckhorst. Albert. Vidmar might yet get in. And did, in fact. Right back losing out to Perini. Paulo Reina. Rangers are finding space. Amato. No free kick that time. Stubbs having a little discussion with Amato about it. There's Larsson. Evans, now Viduka. Wonderful challenge from Albert.
Yeah, he did well there. Marco Viduka's really struggled with the pace of this game tonight. And there are signs just of tiredness creeping in here.
McCann chasing with Scott Marshall, and McCann's in here! Oh, and Stuart Kerr!
It's a great reflex save with his left foot. McCann just too quick for Scott Marshall there. It's the Route 1 ball from Amoruso in behind. And he's too persistent and just too quick for Scott Marshall. And Kerr does well with his left foot.
Meantime, back up the other end. It's going to be a free kick to Celtic. Duca proving to be a real handful. The giant Aussie. Free kick.
A very good one as well, just no takers.
Henry has a disagreement with the barrier down there. Knowing Colin Henry, I'm sure the barrier came off worst.
Well, he's keeping cool anyway. Morten Vikos, I think it was, who hit him here on the track. He trips, he just can't stop. Just a nudge there, and he trips over a cable and into the wall.
I'm sure they'll repair the wall later.
I just wonder how Stefan Mai is feeling, if he's up in the stand watching this now. We saw back in November just how much an ordering off can affect this game when Scott Wilson got his marching orders. There's no question in my mind that his sending off has changed this game completely. As Simon Donnelly is about to make an entrance.
Harold Brabant, the man who makes way. Simon Donnelly comes on for what could be his last Old Firm derby in the league. He's heading for Sheffield Wednesday in the summer, which is 20th Old Firm derby. He's yet to score.
Yeah, they've just pushed Henrik Larsson forward now. Play up front with Marco Viduka. Donnelly just sitting in that midfield area.
Recep trying to do something about Celtic's 2-0 deficit. The corner.
Yeah, it's a good defensive run from Wallace though. Donnelly did well to put Reese to the byline there. And Wallace had the energy to get back and make the block. You have to recognise the spirit of this Celtic side with 10 men still prepared to have a go here, still prepared to come forward.
Larson's corner, it didn't drift out, looked like it might. Sent it back into the danger zone. Here's Weghorst, cannoned off the considerable frame of Amoruso. Reina. Oh, look at the space here. Amato used his arm to control it.
Yeah, it's an expensive one as well because George Alberts was free on his left. He had Neil McCann as well. And it's an expensive handball to give away. Just comes off the upper arm.
Tried his best innocent look, Gabriel Amato. Oh, and it skimmed off Amoruso's head.
Yeah, the flag was up early here on the far side. Larsson just a yard offside. He was running a fraction too early.
Away by Hendry. Weghorst muscling in on Reina. Looking for Larsson. Amoruso clears. Celtic are upping the pace in their efforts to salvage something from this game and in their efforts to deny Rangers from clinching the championship here at Celtic Park. Donnelly. Weghorst. Trying to weave a little bit of magic, Henrik Larsson, and he caught Perini then. That'll be a free kick to Rangers.
Yeah, and he wasn't getting to it. quite often you see frustration creeping into Henrik Larsson's game. No consolation at all for Celtic should they lose this match, but it's been a really courageous performance since they were reduced to 10-1.
Rangers 10 titles in a row last season, of course. I think they took it rather personally. Wallace tripped by Weghorst, who claims he got the ball, and he's going to be summoned now to referee Hugh Dallas.
I think it's a harsh booking. My first impression was that he did take some of the ball here. A yard up on him. And I think the right foot did make contact with the ball there, but I think again it was his reaction that got him into trouble.
He's treading a thin line now. Albert is going to have a long run up for this one. And he's gone for it. Oh, he really wouldn't have wanted to get in the way of that. I think it was Lambert who did. Here's Amato. Going all the way through. Neil McCann. And again had a wild kick of it. An almighty scramble.
Yeah, Celtic stretched big time there in their own six-yard box. Glorious chance for Neil McCann. The effort comes off Lambert, spins to Amato, and he does well here to get past Anone. Weghorst makes the challenge. Stuart Kerr can't get there.
Here's Sergio Perini. Weghorst. Team scrapping furiously for the ball. It's a Rangers throw. And Dick Advocaat quickly out. Trying to size one up. Dragged it wide in the end, though.
Yeah, not his best. Space opened up in front of him. Alan stops here, tries to get across to him. And he drags it wide of the target. But more and more space opening up for George Albert and Rod Wallace. Just in behind the front.
But even as far as attempts at goal are concerned, Celtic remember down to 10 men. After the first half sending off of Stefan Mahi, the Frenchman lost it. Two bookings for dissent. Away by Hendry. An uncompromising clearance, I think you could call that. Reset. Stubbs. Picks out Weghorst. Up towards Reset. And he got it all wrong.
This is the danger now as Rangers break. This is the danger. Celtic just caught with too many players forward.
Well, here's Van Bronckhorst. He's got time to pick out Albert. Whether that was the intention. Rangers spraying the passes around the park now. Their 48th Scottish title is in their sights. In fact, they have a very clear sight of it. Of the 35 league meetings before this one in the 1990s. Rangers romping to 9 titles in a row, of course. missed out last season, got rid of the old team, brought in the new one, and you do.
Yeah, Celtic were always up against it, given the injuries that they had to contend with tonight. They could have done without playing against Rangers with 10 men for most of the game.
Touch. Chelsea have been having a look at Stuart Kerr lately. Celtic are going to make a change with Morten Wieghorst being replaced by Colin Healy, the Irish teenager who's already banged in a few goals against Rangers in a couple of under 21 matches in the past week, and he is considered some prospect.
Yeah, what an introduction for him. He did score in the under 21 match against Rangers in midweek. Of his football education, this will be.
Albert. That's going to go straight through to Kerr. Maruso miskicked, which will give Viduka a sniff, but only that. Mario Reina slid in. Only going for one of his long throws towards Larsson. Amato. Oh, and he was brutally taken out by Alan Stubbs, and that's surely going to be a yellow card.
Yeah, no argument about that at all. Knows it. Mata did well to turn away from him. And I can have no complaints at all about the yellow card for this challenge.
The crime count continues to rise. Rangers remaining league fixtures. Home to Hearts, away to Motherwell, home to Kilmarnock. Would appear they might not matter unless Celtic can produce an epic recovery in the last 20 minutes. Van Bronckhorst. McCann. He's away from Marshall. Lightning pace from McCann, it's only Amato with him, but Anoni says, you're not coming through here, pal.
Fabulous tackle from Rico Anoni. And he's had a smashing game. Once again, it was the pace of McCann stretching Celtic at the back.
Lambert will retrieve this. Simon Donnelly, Sheffield Wednesday bound. Stubbs looking for Larsson, but Claudio Reyna saw it coming. Wallace. Not much Amato could have done with that, to be fair. Healy. Celtic getting a little casual then. This is no time to be casual. Rangers are going to bring on Jonathan Johansson as well soon, just to add to Celtic's problems. Here's Vidar Riise. Donnelly. Larsson. He's had a bit of an off day. McCann. He's had a bit of an on day.
Yeah, he's been superb once again for Rangers. And he has shown again tonight that he's more to his game than playing wide. Very, very effective playing through the middle. There's Gabriel Amato. Best for the bar.
Amato being replaced by the flying Finn, Jonathan Johansson. 17 goals to his name this season. Amato, a huge favourite with the Rangers fans. Not quite able to repeat his heroics of the New Year Old Firm derby.
Yeah, I think the pace of this man is the last thing that Celtic's back three would want to see now. Must be feeling the pace now, Celtic.
Foul by Colin Hendry on Viduka.
I don't know what he's complaining about. Clear challenge from behind there.
Lambert with the free kick. Stubbs is in there, rising with Hendry. And it might come here for Donnelly after this kick from Healy. And Stubbs, the former Bolton Wanderers man. Could he be heading back to English football, I wonder? Linked with Aston Villa earlier in the season. Celtic rejected a bid from them, but John Gregory, Villa boss, is watching today. Watching here at Celtic Park. Starting to party. Quarter of an hour to go. Johansson. Lambert lost out to Johansson. Here's McCann. Now Wallace. Albert is the man over. And George Albert. No way he was going to get to that. And Anoni cleared.
Yeah, Anoni did well once again. George Albert is getting the run of that left-hand side now. It's all the difference when you have a man over.
Rangers on course to complete a century. A century of league victories over Celtic in this famous fixture, which goes back over 100 years. Neil McCann. McCann is through here. He's past the keeper. And Neil McCann has clinched the championship for Rangers. 3-0, it's the magnificent McCann.
Yeah, his pace really has destroyed Celtic at times tonight. And I think it's Scott Marshall who was caught on the wrong side of him here. But there was still a lot of work to do. The ball's played through, Scott Marshall tries to win it, caught on the wrong side. McCann's quick enough to knock it past Kerr and roll the ball into the net. Still a fair bit of work for him to do here as Stuart Kerr came out to close him down. And he handled it beautifully. Celtic just caught short here at the back. Scott Marshall gambled, tried to win it in front of Neil McCann, was caught. And McCann did well.
Delight for Dick. Two goals for Neil McCann. How ironic that the man who broke Rangers' hearts in the cup final last season as part of the Hearts team, beat Rangers, should now seal glory for them. This title race, the race is over. Reset. Johansson. Rangers ready to enjoy themselves a little bit more, perhaps. Johansson.
Johansson could have played it in, chose not to. Waste a bit of time. And Neil McCann smiles and no wonder. And he's quick enough just to knock it past Stuart Kerr. He knows he can make up the ground. What a fine match Neil McCann has had tonight.
Van Bronckhorst with this Rangers corner. McCann on a hat-trick, of course. And Kerr got a touch to that. It'll be another corner.
Dangerous corner, swerving into the back post area there. Can't really blame Stuart Kerr at all tonight. Come into the team recently under difficult circumstances and he's got a decent night.
In comes the corner. Celtic, so depleted, of course, when you look at the injuries they have. They've got a great team sitting in the stands today, with the likes of Gould out, and Blinker, and Burley, and McNamara, McKinley, Mialbi, Reaper, long-term casualty, of course, Tom Boyd suspended. It was always going to be an uphill struggle today, even more so after the first half setting off of Stephen Mahi. Already have some silverware this season, the Scottish League Cup. They won't get their hands on another today because, understandably, the trophy will not be presented at Celtic Park. I'm sure it will be on show at Ibrox next week when Rangers play Hearts, and we'll be there. Full-time whistle here, the players have been ordered to leave the field ASAP. Good idea.
Yeah, I think we've had enough bother for one night. The second half has been something of an anti-climax after the madness that went on in that first 45.
Yes, the scenes in the first half rather spoiled the occasion somewhat. Faduka. And well, that more or less sums up his evening. He hasn't had too many days like this, mind you.
Well, his form has just shaded in recent weeks. Signed a new contract, but his form really has dipped since then.
Tomorrow night, we go from the top two to the bottom two. The scrap for survival. Hearts against Dunfermline. It's 5 o'clock, Sky Sports 1. Top of the table, Rangers are celebrating the 97th major honour in their history. Van Bronckhorst, charge in. Boss smothered it.
I'm still willing to pursue though, Henrik Larsson. Just squeezed out by weight of numbers here, Perini and Colin Hendry closing him down. And eventually it was Stefan Kloss who came out to make the block.
Celtic, of course, the way of a treble for Rangers. These two meet again at the end of the month at Hampden Park in the Scottish Cup final. Just in case you haven't noticed that they do. Depleted Celtic. A spent force here. Challenge from Healy, I think.
Yeah, it was Colin Healy. It's a body check on George Alberts. Alberts just too quick for him there. Again, no real complaints that he's seeing a yellow card.
The Irish teenager gets a yellow card. They're having a party, and it could continue for some time. Rangers fans used to success, of course, but last season they failed to win anything.
Well, they had to take their medicine back here in November when they lost 5-1. But I'm sure this is more than made up for it tonight by clinching the championship here at Celtic Park.
Sweet, sweet revenge for that 5-1 thrashing. The red card on that day was shown to Ranger Scott Wilson. On this day, it was shown to Stefan Mahi. It's a shame, really, that the attack on the referee, Hugh Dallas, in the first half, and the fans who ran on will take something away from this occasion. It's been a polished performance from Rangers, albeit with Celtic rather under strength. Andoni, he's got the throw. Celtic looking for consolation, but it'll only be scant consolation. Reset. Good work from Hendry to marshal that one.
No, I can tell you there is no consolation losing this game, mate. Absolutely none. Celtic simply have to pick themselves up tomorrow morning and look forward to the cup final.
Derek McInnes is coming on for the last few minutes. And he's going to replace George Albert.
It's 59,918. Once again for your excellent support.
Albert being replaced, scored a penalty, his 11th successful spot kick of the season. In between the two Neil McCann goals, he kisses the badge. And Derek McInnes comes on to join what is becoming a mighty celebration.
A generous gesture, I think, by Dick Advocaat, letting Derek McInnes on for the last few moments of what is a historic occasion for Rangers tonight.
Away by Hendry. Oh, reset. And Rob Wallace, and reset here. And it's turned ugly again. Reset certainly clattered into Rod Wallace, and there's plenty of pushing and shoving going on now. And really, they've got to try somehow to calm themselves down. But Hugh Dallas is going to have to produce more cards here. And reset and Rod Wallace.
Yeah, it was a bad challenge by Vidar Reset on Rod Wallace, but it was the reaction of Wallace again that caused the problem here. Wallace just nicks it away. He's caught late by Reset, but it's a reaction, not dissimilar to Stefan Mahi's. And after that, mayhem ensued. Perini is far too keen to get involved as well. And in fact, Wallace has been shown a red.
Rod Wallace sensationally sent off for his retaliation. Both teams are down to 10 men. Rod Wallace can hardly believe it. And after Stefan Mahi saw red in the first half, Rod Wallace sees it in the second half.
Well, it started a bad temper affair and it's finished that way as well. The last thing Hugh Dallas needed, surely felt he was coasting towards a full-time whistle in a match that he would want to forget. Once again, he's having to sort things out. He's over talking to his assistant at the moment. And once again, there were far too many players on either side wanting to get involved.
Well, what a night it's been. Hugh Dallas is calling someone else to him now, and it's Enrico Annone. And he's going to get a yellow card.
So,
well, Rico Annone reacted to Sergio Perini's willingness to get involved in the first place. Smashing game, Lorenzo Amoruso. And he knew he was in for a physical contest against Marco Viduka tonight, and he stood up to it well.
Vidar Rysev was booked for his initial challenge on Rod Wallace in that incident. Here's Donnelly. And it's going to roll through to Stefan Kloss.
Sadly, Q Dallas will be slaughtered tomorrow morning, Ian, because the referee just can't win in this fixture. You see, it's 8 bookings for Celtic, 3 for... putting 2 for Stefan Mai, 3 for Rangers. But I don't think any other referee could have handled this match tonight. The ultimate test, and Q Dallas has come through magnificently.
Eleven yellows brandished in all, and a red for Mahi and for Wallace, and Johansson won't be allowed to get away. He's called back for a foul. We're inside the last minute of normal time, and I think we can safely say this has been one of the more eventful Old Firm derbies, although they are always eventful.
Yeah, it also sets up a huge cup final on May 29 as well, after this.
And now, there's another problem here with Vidmar, and Vidar Rysev's going to be sent off. It's a third red card. Rysev and Vidmar down on the touchline. And another one is off.
Yeah, he knew he was going as well. Didn't hang around to debate it with Hugh Dallas. Sent off for the dressing room right away.
Well, I'm almost lost for words. It's the full-time whistle. Rangers are champions of Scotland. They've reclaimed the title from Celtic. Just to rub it in, their crowning moment comes on the ground of their fierce rivals. So many talking points in this game, though. Hugh Dallas, the referee, hit by a coin, needed stitches in a head wound. Fans rushed on the field. We got back to the football, and a polished performance from Rangers. Bert van Lingen and Dick Advocaat hug each other. There were 3 red cards, and there were 3 goals. Who have completed stage 2 of a tantalising treble. Rangers' 100th league victory over Celtic has made them champions for the 48th time. Last season they missed out on the honours. It was their first trophyless campaign for 12 years. They responded by spending well over £30 million on a new team. A multinational, multi-talented, multi-million pound side. In 1967, Celtic clinched the title with a draw at Ibrox. 32 years on, Rangers have won it at Celtic Park. And right now their fans probably feel that it was worth the wait. Neil McCann, the two-goal hero. He was an inspiration. Last season, a Dutchman steered Celtic to the Scottish title. This season, a Dutchman has steered Rangers to the Scottish title. On a controversial evening in Glasgow. Another chapter is written in the blockbuster that is the Old Firm story. And this chapter has a very happy ending for Rangers. Scottish champions for the 10th time in 11 seasons. Their 48th title, their 97th major honour. That's more than any other club in the world. Minority tried to spoil this great sporting occasion. Rangers didn't let it all get to them. Celtic had to put a really depleted side, and in the end they couldn't quite cope. But what a match, David.
Yeah, I mean, it's exactly the result Rangers wanted. The sending off clearly had a profound effect in the game. But I think in this man here, Lorenzo Amoruso, was quite outstanding against Marco Viduka. And for me, Neil McCann was the best player on show tonight by a long, long way. A lot of eyebrows were raised when Rangers signed him, regarded as one of Dick Advocaat's more modest signings. And he's intended to take his place in that Ibrox dressing room. He really has emerged as a key Rangers player.
A huddle from the Rangers players then. There's a party about to begin across half of Glasgow tonight. These two teams, Celtic and Rangers, have been at each other for well over 100 years, and they're not about to stop now. They'll meet again, of course, at the end of the month in the Scottish Cup final, when Rangers will hope to seal a tremendous treble. They have the Scottish League Cup. They have the new Scottish Premier League trophy. Next, they go up for the cup, the Scottish Cup. An evening to remember for many reasons. It finishes Celtic 0, Rangers 3.
A reminder of the big day of live sport coming up for you tomorrow. There's live Super League at an incident-packed 90 minutes. Rangers have beaten Celtic by 3-0, and in so doing are the new SPL champions. Reaction to all of that after this. New SPL trophy by beating Celtic at Celtic Park, 3-0 tonight. Let's hear now from Dick Advocaat, who's with Martin Geisler.
Dick, given events on and off the pitch tonight, history might not remember the football that was played here this evening, but just for the record, what did you think about that 90 minutes?
Well, you could see the rivalry between the team, and I think about the game, because I'm here for the game, I think we really deserve to win. Over the whole season, if you see that we are 10 points ahead of Celtic, who have almost the same team as last season, I think the team did extremely well the whole year.
You told us all season that you wouldn't be happy, you wouldn't be satisfied, you wouldn't relax until you'd won this championship. Now you've won it. What emotions are you going through this evening?
Well, the expectation is so high. If you're a manager of Celtic or Rangers, everybody expects prizes. And with so many changes what's happened from the beginning on, and if you can win already two games, and even we are still in the cup final, then I think we must thank, first of all, Mr. Murray, that he gives us the possibilities to buy the players. We're very proud of him, and I want to say thank you. And, we're very proud, and hopefully we can do it a little bit more on Ibrox.
Looking back now, in reflection over the last few weeks, the form did drop, it did dip, there were a few bad results. Was there ever a stage where you were slightly concerned you might not be lifting this trophy?
Well, if you come at the end of the season, then you can see that all the other teams, they are playing for the championship or for the relegation. And they give sometimes a little bit more than in the beginning or in the middle of the season. But if you see the whole season, we lost the first game, and almost from the third game on, we were in the first place. So it's a well-deserved year for the Rangers.
Champions League in your sights now next season. How much building are you going to do to this squad over the summer?
Oh, well, we still like to make a party for this game and for this year, and then we start thinking about next season.
The opportunity to do that comes in the final day of the season with the cup final. It's going to be some game now, given Celtic are out for revenge, isn't it?
Yeah, well, hopefully on the football way.
And so say all of us. Thank you for your time, Dick.
Thank you.
So Rangers have beaten Celtic by 3-0 tonight. It's not only their 100th league win over Celtic, it's their biggest Premier League win at Celtic Park and their biggest win there since 1960. Mahé and Reseth of Celtic were red carded. Rod Wallace of Rangers was sent off. Two other bookings beside those earlier of Mahé and Reseth tonight were Kerr, Stubbs, Vighorst, Healy and Anone of Celtic. Three Rangers bookings, Vidmar, McCann and Amato. Well, Celtic had the better of the first half tonight, but it was much more evenly spread in the second half. But by then, This match was won and won by Rangers. So Rangers fans have been celebrating in some style tonight, and amongst them, well, who can you pick out there? Former Rangers players Ian Durrant and Ali McCoist. And in that group too, Gordon Jury of Rangers and Ian Ferguson of Rangers, all celebrating a quite memorable win tonight. As far as Rangers are concerned, a 3-0 win. So the most important statistic of all of that in league terms is that Rangers are now out of sight. They got the win they needed tonight to take the Premier League title. And this is what they've won, the new SPL trophy, which will be presented to Rangers live on Sky Sports before they meet Hearts next week. Let's hear from tonight's man of the match, Neil McCann, who's with Martin Geisler.
Neil McCann, you like this place, don't you? Being given a flag, you like this place, don't you? Cup final here with Hearts last season and then this tonight, how good is it?
Very special. It was a big thing to win the championship. There's a lot of pressure on us the last few games, but the boys have stuck to their guns and a magnificent display today. We thoroughly deserved it.
Does it matter where you won it? Is it special you won it here?
Well, obviously it's special to everybody concerned with Rangers that we won it at Parkhead, but it didn't matter where we won it, as long as we won it, and that's the main thing. We're absolutely over the moon.
It was a bad-tempered game on and off the pitch in parts. What are your thoughts on the 90 minutes of football?
Well, it's always going to be like that in an old firm derby. We knew it wouldn't be any different, but we're glad we've come out on top today and we're champions.
Incredible cup final in store, isn't it?
Hope so, I hope so. But I'm just delighted and we're going to celebrate tonight.
There's a bottle of champagne to help you on your way. Well done, Neil. Congratulations.
Cheers.
And off he goes. Now, I think that bottle of champagne will be uncorked in about 5 seconds. Charlie, Nicholas, Trevor, Stephen were a bit shell-shocked, but Charlie, what was your view overall of that 90 minutes?
Well, a touch embarrassing what happened in the first half with Hugh Dallas and all that stuff, but I think Rangers were the strongest team. As an XL, it's always, you know, an unpleasant taste in your mouth when you lose to your old rivals, but my congratulations, and you know, Rangers certainly deserve to win the championship, and they most certainly deserve to win this game tonight. I thought they were very strong mentally, and I think all round there wasn't a disappointment in the Rangers team. They were excellent tonight and thoroughly deserves their championship.
Do you agree with that, Trevor, that mentally Rangers got it right and they won on merit tonight?
Yeah, there are a lot of different things going into the game. We said beforehand how Celtic was stretched as far as the squad was concerned. We knew that Rangers had the opportunity to go to Parkhead and win the trophy, and that's how it's turned out. Celtic were really stretched. I thought particularly McCann was exceptional. Yeah. He destroyed the Celtic back line, and he was involved in the decisive moments of the game, I feel, particularly that the first goal, which set the whole thing up for Rangers.
Charlie, I think Trevor has said it. Neil McCann tonight, exceptional performance from him, and rightly man of the match.
Well, even early doors, Jim, I mean, Rangers got off to a good start. Good stuff from McCann, who tormented Anoni for the first half, and also tormented Scott Marshall on many occasions too. It was a good link-up play from Rangers. They always look capable of doing things. You see, he's working on Anoni in all sorts of angles. As soon as you turn your back, McCann, you can be in trouble. But there was no doubt, even at the back, Rangers were strong. Amoruso was time and time again. Again, second half, as I say, McCann was really annoying and a pest to Scott Marshall all night. Rangers were comfortable.
This is why Dick Advocaat wanted to get a hold of Neil McCann and take him to Rangers, wasn't it, Trevor?
Well, to be honest, he's fulfilled his potential a lot earlier than I think anybody at Rangers could have envisaged. He's settled in so well. I mean, so you've got to take your hat off to him. He's surrounded by multi-million pound players and he looks every part the star, and you know, full credit to him.
And also, Trevor, you know, he's starting to play in the centre-forwards role. He's done it for Scotland at national level. Yeah. And now he's doing it tonight at the top level you can. This is a lovely goal, wasn't it? I mean, the confidence to go around Stuart Kerr comfortably like this.
Still had all to do there when he approached Kerr. His first touch was excellent, took it well past him and stroked it in. It was a great finish.
Well, as you can imagine, Celtic are hugely disappointed tonight because Rangers have won the league on their patch. Let's hear from Joseph Venglos, who's with Martin.
Joseph, you've just watched the story of the game with us, the goals that went past your side this evening. How disappointed are you tonight?
Of course, derby always is unpredictable. It was one of those, and it's difficult to speak about it. From my point of view, players show character. They work hard, especially the same as I have been with 10 players on the field. And I think later I will see that game all, and I will make my assessment of that.
Was it a lack of discipline that you let your team down this evening?
Of course, players under the difficult circumstances, they have to control themselves. I think about those two.
But it was not easy for the players, I can tell you very honestly. And of course, I don't want to speak about it anymore.
You had a number of players missing this evening through injury and so on. Is that the reason for the defeat? Would you put it down to simply the lack of first team players available?
Always when players are injured, it's no good for a team. But those who has been on the field, they work hard. And, you know, as I said, derby is always unpredictable. And it was like that.
I think you would possibly agree the league was lost at the start of this season. There were too many points dropped when you were trying to get a team together, waiting to buy players and so on.
I don't want to make any analysis of the league now. And, of course, we played against a good team, well-prepared team, and we tried to do our best.
Let me ask you this in that case. There's been a lot of suggestion, a lot of talk about Kenny Dalglish arriving here at Celtic Park next season. Will you still be here to manage Celtic next season?
I think you have to speak about that with our officials. I am doing my job and the rest, it's out of my possibilities to analyze that.
As far as you're concerned, though, you do want to stay here as Celtic head coach?
No, I don't want to speak about that. I think it's okay. And after that game, you should not speak about those things.
Okay.
Please, thank you.
Thank you for your time, Joseph.
Well, good for Joseph Venglos speaking to Martin Geisler tonight. Good on him. Well, Rangers fans are still inside Celtic Park and they'll celebrate well into the night. Their side won 3-0 tonight and in doing so made history by clinching the league title at Celtic Park for the very first time. Reaction coming up after this. Porter, you'll celebrate long, long into the night tonight. These fans there inside Celtic Park tonight have seen a quite incredible game, an incident-packed game, and Rangers ran out by winners. 3-0, and in doing so, are the new SPL champions. And as we said earlier, this is what they won, the new SPL trophy. 3-0 Rangers. We knew it would be explosive, but not that explosive. 3-0. And 3 red cards, Charlie. What a game altogether.
Well, we knew from the top that it was going to be a lot of tension, a lot of passion involved in this game. And Celtic were always a team under pressure. Both myself and Trevor thought that before kick-off. They were under strength, but it was only really Scott Marshall, who was a new addition to Celtic's starting lineup. He was caught out here, along with, may I say, two or three other Celtic defenders. It was a wonderful start for Neil McCann and Rangers. And as soon as that went in, I thought Celtic were going to really be tested then.
Yeah, that was the start the Rangers wanted. It settled the nerves, gave them the belief. I think they had a fair bit of that before the game started, mind you, having seen now that the Celtic lineup was so disturbed through injury. Celtic tried to get back in. So Mahi doing a lot of work on that left-hand side early on. That was one effort that they had. It was never really going to bother Klos.
No, there was never really too much to test Klos. I mean, we have to compliment this Klos with the best chance Celtic had in the night. He just drags it a little wide. Credit to the goalkeeper, he's been under scrutiny lately. They don't think he's quite as good as Charbonnier, but he's just lifted another championship, so he's proven the point. Walter Joseph's team never really showed the fluency for me tonight. Not the Rangers at times. I thought Rangers were the better of the two. This was a moment of madness for Stephen Mahé. Shello Cardiff, he simply lost the head. And I think he's probably said something that Hugh Dallas didn't like. And Hugh Dallas doesn't accept that. And he had to make a decision. Now McCann was yellow carded and Mahé had to fall. So it was no surprise. When he lost the head, Hugh Dallas had to make a decision.
And Trevor, was that Trevor the turning point, as David Provan said in co-commentary? Rangers were one up, but was that the turning point?
Well, the goal was a turning point, but that was as crucial, I think. You know, when you go down to 10 men in an old firm game, you're really struggling. As Rangers struggled in the previous game at Parkhead when Scott Wilson went off, you're never quite at the races again, and they struggled from that point onwards.
Yeah, that was the time. This is another chance for Reserve. A bad miss it, and they scrambled clear. I mean, you remember that Scott Wilson got sent off in that last game, and we're complimenting Joseph Venglos for his tactics. Well, tonight, Advocat won it because he played McCann through the middle. This was the incident that just embarrasses me as a Scotsman. It really was terrifying to see this happen to our best referee in the business. Van Bronckhorst had to get there and get rained with coins. Fortunately, it didn't happen. It didn't. He didn't get hit. I didn't think this was a sufficient claim for a penalty. I thought it was a weak one. But Hugh Dallas was strong. And after what happened to him, I'm not going to complain too much, well, because he had to make a decision.
Yeah, the game had just gone into that 2 or 3 minutes of madness, and George Albert takes full advantage of that decision from Hugh Dallas, which we thought was 50-50, could have gone either way. We've seen them given, we've seen them left by the referees. Hugh Dallas decided to give it, and that really put Rangers into the driving seat.
Yeah, that was a game beyond it, Jim. I mean, there was no doubt about that. Stuart Kerr was very fortunate. You know, Neil McCann, clever as always, testing him. And just sheer reaction, it was the definite yellow card. Couldn't do too much about it. He was put under a lot of pressure. This was a lucky save for Stuart Kerr. He'll be glad to see that again over the top. He tried to read the bounce, actually. It's a great strike from Amoruso. We may say I thought it was absolutely superb tonight. But, you know, they threatened and they huffed and puffed at times, Celtic, but you never believed they were going to score.
Yeah, there's another effort there coming in, this time from Bradbach. We saw once or twice early in the game that he turned the defence, but that was the only time in the second half. He had a good strike on goal in the end.
How good is this guy, Trevor? You know, as a forward, as a winger, you played winger, but he can play centre forward. How good can this guy go?
He's already, you know, going towards the top. He's doing well for Scotland, never mind for Rangers. And his ability, his pace, he's absolutely magnificent. We were talking about this guy as well, Amato being a threat. Thought he had a very, very good game. McCann just misses out there. But Amato, I think you've got to say that he had a very good game today.
Do you think Amato's played himself in, guys, to stay at Ibrox?
Yeah, well, I said it last week, Jim, didn't I? I mean, I thought his performance last week was good enough to merit that. This was, to round off, an absolutely sensational individual performance from Neil McCann. Cool, composed and classy, and it's a nice way to sum him up tonight.
Well, he always felt it was going to come at some point. As Rangers, as Celtic rather, tried to get themselves back into the game, always difficult with 10 men. Neil McCann taking full advantage, as Charlie said, cool, calm and collected. And it was just a matter of putting the ball in the net, and he did it comfortably.
He must be delighted. I mean, he's came there in his first season, he spent a lot of money, he had to rebuild. And they've done the business tonight, they've taken away the embarrassment. This is another embarrassing episode for us tonight, where they all get involved. Who says that the foreigners are not passionate about an Old Firm?
Well, that is true, Charlie. That is right.
You know, we can complain a long time about him if we like. You know, but he's an Englishman against a Scandinavian. It's all, you know, battle galore. And Hugh Dallas, I mean, David was right to make the point. How could anybody control an incident like that? It is unbelievable that one man has got to take the responsibility. Yeah. And a shocking challenge from Big Dida. Certainly knew straight away and definitely deserved a red card on its own, never mind two yellows.
Absolutely. Players playing in those games, in these games, have got to show some self-control, and Dr. Wenger said beforehand that some players just didn't show that today, and Celtic paid the penalty.
Well, Charlie, they will celebrate, as we've said, long into the night. There's McCann.
Well, could easily have been a
tonight.
Celtic player at one time, Jim, and they'll be disappointed in that. He was a match winner tonight.
Rangers won it, and they are champions. Let's hear now from Rangers skipper Lorenzo Amoruso.
Lorenzo, it's noisy inside Celtic Park, it's noisy outside Celtic Park. How big a night is this for you personally?
Great night, I think. Well, I told this week we were in good condition and we came here for to try to win. I think today we deserve to win this game because the performance of the team has been wonderful, marvellous, I think. And at the end of the game, I think the 3-0 is the right result.
You've been involved in some big teams and some big games in your career. How much does it mean to you personally to captain the side that lifts the Scottish Premier League trophy?
Yeah, that's, I think, the best trophy in my life and also the best game I played in my life, I think, because, you know, when you win a league, it's always great for me, but for everybody, I think.
Over the season as a whole, how satisfied were you with the way the team played?
Well, I think we left just a couple of games, especially then the United home and St. Johnston away. But I think so far during the season we have done much better than the other teams. Absolutely, yes.
Lorenzo, thanks for your time.
Thanks, Eli.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Amoruso happy tonight. Well, Charlie, Rangers won this game tonight, but over the piece, over the season, where was the title won and lost, do you feel?
Well, I think it was lost at the start of the season. Rangers didn't start too impressively, and they took time to get gelled together, which was no surprise to us all. But the damage was done in Celtic's behalf was through Fergus McCann and other people in the hierarchy at Celtic not going out and letting Dr. Joseph get enough bodies back in and doing it quickly into the season. They took far too long to get Joseph Venglos into the manager's seat. And because of that, Celtic took ages to get going in this championship. Their away form simply wasn't good enough. Their home form was fantastic. But when they started to play, they were an exciting and good-looking side, but it took far too long.
Do you agree with that, Trevor, that because they dragged their feet,
yeah,
Celtic suffered?
But they hold themselves back into it as well, you know, over the period as well. And if you look back to last week, that defeat to St Johnson really knocked the stuffing out of them. Rangers play Aberdeen the following day, win 3-1, and the tables turned. Rangers give themselves the opportunity to win the league at Parkhead.
Charlie, this is a big question. Do you feel Kenny Dalglish will be involved at Celtic Park sooner than later? The big talk is that he'll be in charge of Celtic as they go into the cup final next
week.
Well,
month. I think he will. I mean, it might take longer than people would like, but because I think there's still some members of the PLC Celtic board who are quite against Kenny Dalglish coming, and I think Fergus McCann from a distance is still involved in that. But I think people like Dermot Desmond, in particular, you know, Alan McDonald, who's friendly with Kenny, and Kenny now wants the job.
And to take the deflection away from what Celtic have just lost tonight, it would be absolutely tremendous for Celtic fans if Dalglish was to come on board now and start looking to the rest of the season. They've got a cup final, and then they've got the preparation for the summer. They can't afford this summer to let what happened last summer continue, and I think Dalglish will look forward to joining Celtic very soon.
It goes on and on and on, doesn't it? 3-0 Rangers tonight. Well, that is it for tonight. The next line, you could be about to witness football history. You did, and Rangers are the first winners of the Bank of Scotland Scottish Premier League. Tragically, what you also saw were some quite unacceptable scenes that can't help but take the gloss off such a huge occasion. We'll see you tomorrow for Hearts Against Dunfermline. Until then, bye for now.